So it's the 14th of May, a Saturday, and it's raining. It's been raining all day long, but luckily not a heavy rain, just a misty, cold, kind of bone-chilling rain. Not enough to start stop archaeology. So we've been working on trying to get this test excavation unit deeper. It's 2.5 meters by 5 meters, and I think we've finally gotten out of the layer of styrofoam. I believe we're getting into the layer of the 19th century and pretty soon 18th century material, which is where we really want to see what the types of preservation are and whether this is going to be an area we want to open up for larger excavations to understand the French city of St. Louis and even more importantly, the Native American mound building community that existed here at this point in time.
First, I found the top of the French bottle over here, and then I found a piece of the blue and white pottery over in this corner.
All right, so this is a time diagnostic artifact. It's the third most important artifact we've found so far in the dig. Who does it belong to? I know Justin would love to have this artifact for his own private collection, but no way, man. This belongs to the owner of the property. And the owner of the property, whether we find gold coins, whether we find old French wine bottles, all of it belongs to him. Doesn't belong to me, doesn't belong to the students, doesn't belong to the city of St. Louis. Now, what he decides to do with it, whether he donates it to the Missouri Historical Society or to Cahokia Mounds, or whether he glues it on a board and puts it over his bed, I don't care. My purpose in the excavation is not to find loot. My purpose in the excavation is to find time diagnostic artifacts. Oh my God, Justin, look what you just found. You found a piece of pottery. You see how this piece of pottery has blue edge on it? And underneath the edging, there is a design. This is called blue feather edge. We didn't even stage this. You just found it that way. This is so awesome. Blue feather edge, again, is a very diagnostic kind of china that usually dates from Civil War period or earlier. And so finding that and this together without any styrofoam. Justin, is there any styrofoam down there? Yay! Means we have passed away from the styrofoam horizon, which was the leftover from the 1970s, and we are now getting into layers of undisturbed earlier 19th century and hopefully then 18th century material. Blue feather edge pottery, and a free-blown wine bottle. Really nice discoveries. Yeah, okay, this is part of a decorative, the details on the building. It had this glazed sort of roof tiles and downspouts. And when they bulldoze the building down, we get a lot of this material. We save it, we wash it, I count it, I weigh it, and then we do not keep, does not go to the Missouri Historical Society. It's not a time-critical piece. But that one glass neck bottle, that's really important. That's exciting for me. So go ahead and put it in that bucket. Yep. French colonial period, and then this is called blue feather edge. It's a kind of a ceramic that was made in England, and it was commonly imported up into Missouri from around 1810 up to about 1860. And so those are two really nice sort of time diagnostics for it.